Thank you. Bride requests that the guests be seated. Dearly beloved, we are assembled here in the presence of God to join together this man and this woman in holy marriage, which is instituted of God, regulated by his commandments, blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ, and to be held in honor among all men and women. Let us therefore reverently remember that God has established and sanctified marriage for the welfare and happiness of humankind. Our Savior has declared that a man shall leave his father and mother and cleave unto his wife. By his apostles he has instructed those who enter into this relation to cherish a mutual esteem and love, to bear with each other's infirmities and weaknesses, to comfort each other in sickness, trouble, and sorrow, in honesty and industry, to provide for each other and for their household in temporal things, to pray for and encourage each other in the things which pertain to God, and to live together as the heirs of the grace of life. For as much as these two persons, Michael and Rhonda, have come to this place to be made one in this holy estate, if there be any here present who knows any just cause why they may not lawfully be joined in the marriage, I require that person now to speak or ever after to hold his peace. On this glad day, there being no objection and no impediment, let us unite with this couple in their first prayer together as they are joined as husband and wife. Let us pray. Almighty and blessed God, whose presence is the happiness of every condition, and whose favor hallows every relation, we beseech thee to be present and favorable unto these thy servants, that they may be truly joined in the honorable estate of marriage, in the covenant of their God. As thou hast brought them together by thy providence, sanctify them by thy Spirit, giving them a new frame of heart fit for their new estate, and enrich them with all grace, whereby they may enjoy the comforts, undergo the cares, endure the trials, and perform the duties of life together as becometh Christians, under thy heavenly guidance, through Jesus Christ our Lord. I should like to share with you now some words of the wise Apostle Paul, well-known chapter on love in 1 Corinthians. Though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels, and have not love, I am become a sounding brass or tinkling cymbal. And though I have the gift of prophecy, and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith, so that I could remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned and have not love, it profits me nothing. Love suffers long and is kind. Love envies not. Love wants not itself, is not puffed up, does not behave itself unseemly, seeks not its own, is not easily provoked, thinks no evil, rejoices not in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth, bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. Whether there be prophecies, they shall fail. Whether there be tongues, they shall cease. Whether there be knowledge, it shall vanish away. For we know but in part, and we prophesy in part. But when that which is perfect is come, and that which is in part shall be done away. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I understood like a child. I thought like a child. But when I became an adult, I put away the childish things. For now we see through a glass dark, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then shall I know even as also I am known. Now abides faith, hope, and love. These three, but the greatest of these is love.
Amen. Who presents this woman to be led?
Your mother and I.
Keep you only unto him so long as you both shall live. The lighting of the unity candle represents two lives being lived separately. And by the lighting of the central candle, these two lives become one.
Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
For as much as you, Michael John, and you, Rhonda, have covenanted together in holy wedlock, and have sealed their vows by giving and receiving a ring, I, therefore, by virtue of the authority given to me as a minister, pronounce your husband and wife married according to the ordinance of God and the laws of this state. You may do so. Ladies and gentlemen, we're pleased to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Michael John